All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, we're here to do a comparison of some of the sprues of the Hobby Boss, brand new Su-17 M4 Fitter K, and the Kitty Hawk, a few months old Su-17 M3 M4 Fitter K. Now, there's plenty of videos on the net. Most of them say something bad about the Kitty Hawk kit. I've not looked at it yet. As you can see, all the sprues are still sealed. I'm not going to do a review of that kit because it could, no matter whether I like it or I don't like it, it's going to come across as either being with people or being against people. I'm just going to compare the sprues of the two kits, see how they compare, and you can decide for yourself. All right, let's set these aside. Both of them do have very nice box art. Can't fault them on that. My Hobby Boss SU-17 review is going up, or by the time this is up, it will have been up. Let's start with fuselage. First criticism that we've seen throughout is how many pieces the Kitty Hawk fuselage is. So we're with the Hobby Boss, we got one sprue. And with the Kitty Hawk, if I remember correctly from all the reviews, it takes 6 sections to put the Kitty Hawk fuselage together. So, let's just start with the nose of both. The nose of the Hobby Boss, the nose of the Kitty Hawk, and as you can see, the Kitty Hawk's got open front vents. The detail on the Kitty Hawk seems to be a little sharper, crisper. You know, the hump is already on the Hobby Boss one, where you're going to add it to the Kitty Hawk one. The wings attached with round parts here and with a slot in there. Okay, now this is the center section right here. Again, detail on the Kitty Hawk looks better. Hobby Boss looks a little more plain. It looks like the wings are set in on the Kitty Hawk and pretty much flush on the Hobby Boss. Not sure how well that fit'll go. So, from detail to detail right now, the Kitty Hawk detail's better. And then this would be the bottom. Speed brakes are open, and speed brakes don't look like they open on the Hobby Boss, but they do on the Kitty Hawk. So fuselage wise, just detail, Kitty Hawk wins. Now ease of assembly, obviously Hobby Boss is going to win, because as we've seen from some builds of this, getting these sections to fit together without a seam line is sometimes a problem, or always a problem. So, again, ease of assembly goes to Hobby Boss, detail goes to Kitty Hawk. All right, let's see what else we can look at. Move all these out of the way. Next, let's see where the wings are in here. Kitty Hawk has a full engine, where the Hobby Boss has no engine. All right, here's the Kitty Hawk wings. And let's get us out some Hobby Boss wings. Make a little more order amidst this chaos. Wings. Wings. detail section. Elevators, we got there. Okay, these are the outer wings, so we don't need those right now. So, inner wings, wing roots. Here's the connection point for the Hobby Boss ones. Yeah, I mean, it's a big connection point, so it should be okay. As long as we make it smooth. Here's the connection point for the Kitty Hawk, which it's recessed and has a smaller connection point. So again, it could work, depending on your skills and how much patience you have. See, this does have the outer wings right there. So let's start with the detail on the top part. Again, they've got more, Kitty Hawk has more open ports, closed ports. These rails on the Kitty Hawk one are better detailed, look more realistic. These are just rails here. Flaps, positionable, not positionable. So Kitty Hawk is winning on detail. The bottom. So, actually the bottoms look pretty close except for those back rails. The rivets are more pronounced on the back rails of the Kitty Hawk. And there are no real rivets on those rails right here on the Hobby Boss. But you can put those in. Hobby Boss has built-in landing gear detail. Kitty Hawk has built-in landing gear detail. And again, it's really close. I'm going to still say Kitty Hawk barely by nose on that one. Elevators. Sorry, cat got in the way. Elevators, both elevators are one piece. Let's get them matched up. Hobby Bosses seem a little bigger, but then there's a slat running along the back of the Kitty Hawk ones. But the probes on the end, Kitty Hawk one looks more in scale than the Hobby Boss one. Like I said, they're both in one piece. And let's look at the tail section. Hobby Boss tail section does not have a positional rudder, but it has very good detail. Kitty Hawk tail section has positional rudders, and again the detail looks a little crisper on the Kitty Hawk one, but some are going to ask, is it out of scale? I don't know. When you get a primer and a paint and a wash on it, how's it going to look? It's going to stand out more? It's going to be too big? Until you put it together, you won't know. I'm still going with detail-wise, Kitty Hawk is ahead of Hobby Boss. Ease of build is still going to be Hobby Boss, unless you want a lot more detail. You know, you've got your flaps, one-piece flaps right here on the Kitty Hawk kit. Flaps are not adjustable on the Hobby Boss kit. These are the outer wings, and these are movable, where on the Hobby Boss kit, these are the outer wings for the open, and then there's another set of outer wings for closed. You choose open or closed. Now, of course, lots of people think this being able to position the wings is a gimmick. That's up to you. But detail for detail, they both have positionable aileron or leading edge slats. Detail's still a little better. They both have positionable ailerons, but the Kitty Hawk has positional flaps as well. So, who's winning? You guys are going to have to make that decision for yourself. Because as I said, you've seen the build of the Kitty Hawk kit. You have not seen the build of the Hobby Boss kit as of May 14th when I'm doing this video. So, when someone does a build video, then you'll have the ultimate way to decide. Now, most of this is engine parts, and the hobby bus has no engine. And this has got inject molded wheels where the hobby bus is rubber. Let me open this up so we can make a size comparison. Okay. Here's a rear wheel from the hobby bus kit. They're made of rubber. These are in two halves. Neither are weighed on wheels. Looks like the hobby bus tire's a little bigger. Is that right? Is that wrong? I don't know. I just don't know. But you've got the engine. You've got detail parts, which are just as good. You've got guns here, which have hollowed out ends, which the hobby bus does not have. One-piece pylons, which the hobby bus has. Trying to find something on here we can compare. And the nose cone. That's the nose cone of the Kitty Hawk. Find the nose cone for the hobby bus. So we know the hobby bot or the Kitty Hawk nose cone, the whole front Kitty Hawk part is wrong. So they're both shaped different. Can you see that? Maybe if I held it, not like a contortionist. But the shape is different on them. This one's got the open for the glass piece in there. Hobby Boss just has the outline molded in for the panel. Now, from what I recall, this just sits in between. These fuselage halves right here. Now, for some reason, I thought there was a big ejector pin mark or ejector pin thing right here. I have to check the directions because these look good on the inside here. Well, we'll check the directions when we get to it. So, a lot of this isn't going to be in the Hobby Boss kit. I want to find the cockpit details. Okay, we're going to look at cockpits now. Cockpit parts. Then we're going to talk about that nose cone again. So, instrument panel, Hobby Boss, instrument panel, Kitty Hawk. Close. Bulkhead, where's the bulkhead? Bulkhead Hobby Boss, where the ejector seat rail is, bulkhead Kitty Hawk. That one I would give to Kitty Hawk. A little more detail. Let's see. Kitty Hawk side cockpit walls. Hobby Boss side cockpit wall 1 and 2. Let's see. Ejector seat. It's got cushion. Sides, you're going to add parts to. Back. Heads up display right there. So, for ejector seat, the Hobby Boss I say it's gonna win. Except I don't like the harnesses, but you can just send those off and replace them. But it's got a lot more side detail, headrest detail, detail for the back where the rail goes. So, for ejector seat, I give that one to Hobby Boss. Cockpit. Where's the cockpit tub for this Kitty Hawk one? There it is. Cockpit tub. Sides. So these are the sidewalls. I don't know what I'm looking at. These are the sidewalls for the cockpit tub. It goes into this floor. And these are the panels that go on the sides right there. Oops, right there. The Hobby Boss, it's all one piece. So, those two pieces there, on the sides where all the knobs are, are these here on the Kitty Hawk kit. So as you can see, much greater detail. All right, now we were going to talk about the nose cone. Get this over here. This one, and I need this one, sorry, lots of parts for these. Okay. Now, as we've seen, where I put the nose cone, try to do this in a way it makes sense. The nose cone, which you put this clear piece in, which does or doesn't fit well, depending on who you listen to. And then you glue these two halves of the shot cone together, and the nose cone sticks on the end. And then it fits in this round part right here on both sides of the fuselage. And as you can see, this has tabs in it. Right there. This doesn't. So the nose cone wants to move like this until you get it centered. From the front, when you're looking at it, you've got this attachment point, this attachment point. You can see those when you're looking down the front, and they look unsightly. Because that's not how the real aircraft looks. Hobby Boss has actual detail. You see that? Rivets in the nose section. Okay. Its attachment point here. Actually, that's not an attachment point. That's a spree gate. So you're just going to cut that off. So the first attachment points are back here behind where the nose cone's gonna go. The nose cone, these two intake halves go together, and the nose cone sits on the end of it. And this was the nose cone, which didn't have the clear part, it just had the framing for the clear part. So these are gonna sit on the end, this is gonna sit on the end of that. It's gonna make it like a real intake, which is going to slide and lock into here. So when you look down it, you're going to see the actual intake, not attachment points. So, as far as the shot cone is concerned, the winner is definitely Hobby Boss. You're going to be able to look down the front of it, and it's going to look more realistic. Now there is finally an aftermarket one for the Kitty Hawk, and I did order it. So when it comes in, we'll take a look at it. So that's the controversial nose cone discussion. So what it's looking like, and we're going to take a look at some of these weapons here. So from a weapon-for-weapon standpoint, we're not going to go into much detail on the weapons because the weapons don't seem to be as controversial as the rest of the kit. But you got hollowed-out points for the rockets. And this one has got hollowed-out points for the rockets and for the tail section where they launch from. Detail on both is good. They're both in halves. You've got a lot of weapons for both. I'm sure there are some differences in the loadouts, because the Kitty Hawk actually gives you a second version. And there's more weapons. So the Kitty Hawk gives you a lot more weapons. A lot more of a loadout. But, again, that's not the controversy with the whole Kitty Hawk kit. And Kitty Hawk comes with photo etch harnesses. You saw on the seat didn't have any. And the only photo etch with the Hobby Boss kit was this little bit right here. Okay. If you wanted to use the decals for the instrument panels, they're right there. The decal sheet on the Kitty Hawk one is larger than the decal sheet on the Hobby Boss one, which is going towards more detail on the Kitty Hawk than the Hobby Boss. Kitty Hawk decals. Hobby Boss decals. These are flatter. They seem much more closely cut than these. One thing I did not like on these was how the shark mouth was all one piece. You have to wrap it around. But decal selection, especially for the weapons and the stencils, goes to Kitty Hawk. Because look for yourself. If you're going for options and pure detail, Kitty Hawk wins. If you're going for quality, Kitty Hawk wins. These are okay, and I'm going to use them. Or I'm going to order some aftermarket from Linden Hill. I haven't decided yet. So, again, no one is online yet has built this Hobby Boss kit, as far as I know. So we know how the Kitty Hawk goes together because there's several build videos. Instructions. Let me move all these boxes out of the way. Kitty Hawk, nice colored instruction manual. For some reason, their call arts are attached to the middle of it, but you've got many more schemes. Don't know why they attach them that way. Sprue maps. So, the Kitty Hawk kit is far more detailed than the Hobby Boss kit. The Hobby Boss kit is going to be easier to assemble. Less parts, less seam lines. But the Kitty Hawk has more detail. So, what do you look for in a kit? Do you want the detail, where you've got a nose cone that you should replace, and there is a replacement available for $9 from, I think it's HAD. I'll look that up real quick. Replace the nose cone, fix all the joints on the six-piece fuselage, and you've got more detail and more options for the kit. Straight out of the box, no aftermarket, which means no aftermarket nose cone. Then you see right here the nose cone of the Kitty Hawk, or the Hobby Boss. It looks like an intake nose cone. Oops, sorry. Looks like an intake nose cone. So, the fronts go together the same. Landing gear bay cockpit on top of that. You know, there's no engine in the Hobby Boss, just the exhaust. So, the debate's going to rage on. Once the Hobby Boss is built, people are going to take a look at it. You know, you got to put the spine on, after including the six sections, and you got to put the halves of the spine together and put it on so there's more seam lines. Whereas on this one, the spine is already part of it, and you're just putting the tail on. So, there's that. This one comes with the ME and the M4 version, so there's choices. Only two color callouts, like I said, and for some reason Kitty Hawk crams all theirs in there. Far more weapons in the Kitty Hawk. There's the whole weapons callout for the Kitty Hawk. And there's the weapons callout for the Hobby Boss. So many more weapons. So, from a weapons point of view, whatever you want your loadout to be, this one has a better selection. Putting all the parts on, wings on. You know, you're building the landing gear bays up pretty much the same. Sorry, I'm not holding very well. Like I said, this one's got a movable wing option. This one, Hobby Boss, you choose whether you want the wings swept or the wings open. The wings are open, you use the leading edge slats. There's two sets of wings, so there's the open wings with the leading edge slats and the closed wings, swept wings with no leading edge slat. That's functional. This one, you've got one wing, leading edge slat, open. It's going to look like that. You can see right here where the connection point is. And this is open. And it doesn't show it closed, but you just sweep it back to close it because this moves. So, again, ease of use or ease of build. And there's the weapons call out for Kitty Hawk. Weapons call out for Hobby Boss. You can see a bigger selection. So, I guess I should wrap this up. Ease of use, or ease of build, is going to be right to Hobby Boss. I mean, even looking at this picture right here, looking down the nose cone, even that looks more realistic than that one. So the nose cone's the biggest issue on the Kitty Hawk kit, and the six-piece fuselage. Or, if you're counting the spine, that's the 10-piece fuselage. It's going to come down to personal preferences. The cost, Kitty Hawk was slightly cheaper than the Hobby Boss, but only by a few dollars. But it's more detail, it's got more options. Hobby Boss, nice quick build, you can get some good aftermarket for it. You get aftermarket for the Kitty Hawk, but out of the box, what do you want to do? You want the easy build? You want the complex build with more detail? You can do the easy build and add more detail, but you're going to have to cut open some panels and stuff, like the front fence. You know, like these front air scoops. They're open. They're open on the Kitty Hawk kit, not on the Hobby Boss kit. Wings, these are pretty well flush for the Hobby Boss. set in for the Kitty Hawks. You're going to have stronger wing support on the Kitty Hawk. I'm not going to say which is better because I need to build them both first. I'm going to stick with, for ease of view, ease of build, Hobby Boss. For detail, it's going to take more time. It's going to be more complex. You're going to have to work harder on it. But we are modelers. Kitty Hawk. Kitty Hawk fans will take the Kitty Hawk. Hobby Boss fans will take the Hobby Boss. They'll argue back and forth about which one's better. I'm not going to get in that argument. Those are my 2 cents. So, let me know what you think in the comments. This is all I'm going to say about these kits, because there's enough controversy right now. So, remember, don't be a kit collector. Be a kit builder. I got 2 of these, and eventually I'm going to build them both. And I'm not even sure which one I'm going to build first. Because honestly, I have built the SMER one, the SMER one, and it was awful. So, either one of these is going to be a huge improvement from that kit. So, there you go. Neither one's perfect. Both are going to have issues. You decide. Let me make the decision for you. Don't let other people make the decision for you. You've seen a basic sprue comparison. Make the decision for yourself. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.